on my way. So for today, I'm going to be sharing with you winter makeup mistakes which one must avoid for a flawless looking makeup. So this video is all about all the tips which I really wanted to share, specifically about winter. So here are just some simple tips which will make your makeup look more smooth and flawless. So yeah, if you're interested in this video, then please keep on watching. But before that, don't forget to like, share and comment, and also subscribe to my channel and hit that bell icon. So now without further ado, let's get started with the video. So these tips are basically more helpful for a beginner. Basically focus on beginner's makeup videos more. So that's the reason I'm doing this video for today. Yeah, that's pretty much it. Let's get started with the video. So the first tip is to moisturize really well. So you have seen me saying this many a times on my channel, to moisturize, hydrate. All this happens when you really intensify your skincare. So I will be sharing a skincare video as well. But for now, the first and the main thing is to moisturize your skin. So if you're looking for a good moisturizer, you don't need to invest in any expensive brand. You can definitely try Biotic moisturizer or Pond's moisturizer. Both of them are really hydrating. Even the Garnier Wrinkle Lift is really hydrating. So the first thing is to moisturize. And if you really need an extra care, go for a moisturizer and also go for a cold press oil. So this is the pomegranate seed oil from Nykaa. So if you're looking for a really nice affordable face oil and you don't want to buy serums, you can definitely try Nykaa oil. This one retails for 500 rupees, but Nykaa natural products are always on discount, like on 20 to 30% discount. So you can definitely buy these products when they are actually on discount. So when I got this for 300 rupees. So getting 30 ml of product for 300 rupees is worth, and this will gonna last for a really long time. Trust me, I've been using these oils for a very long time. So you can mix both of these and you will get a really hydrating glowing skin. So first I'm gonna do this and I'm gonna show you how I like to use them. So I'm gonna tone my face. Toning is really important, so don't forget a toner as well. So I'm gonna take few drops of this oil. Now I'm gonna massage this oil really well into my skin. Next, I'm gonna apply this moisturizer. I take a good amount of moisturizer. That's it. So you can see the skin is glowing. My skin looks much healthy now, and this is the first thing which people avoid, and they certainly skip this step. And even if they moisturize really less. So if you applied a facial oil or a facial serum, you really don't need a primer. So I will be skipping a primer. So the second thing that you should avoid in winters is to avoid using a brush for your face. Brushes makes your face look and your base looks really heavy with that. For a beginner and for also for winters, use a damp sponge, because that way you won't be using a lot of product and your skin will look glowy natural as well. So this is a damp sponge from Miniso. I really love Miniso products. And the second confusion lies between a foundation and a concealer. Either go for concealers, like these kind of concealers. If I have to get ready in just 2 minutes, I will go for a concealer of these kind of concealer to just conceal my under eyes or any blemish on my face. But I also equally love this Lakme Perfecting Foundation, because this is really sheer in coverage. So if I have to go for a foundation, I only go for this foundation or the Makeup Revolution Stick Foundation. That foundation got a really nice coverage, but that looks pretty much heavy. So for a daily basis, I totally recommend Lakme Perfecting Liquid Foundation and also a concealer. But for today, I'm going to show you how I like to do my base in winters with a foundation and a damp sponge. So I'm gonna shake my foundation in the foundation, the back of my hand. I'm gonna use my finger to make it a little warm. I'm gonna dot it all over my face. This foundation is really affordable. Like, it's just for 140 rupees. So if you're a beginner, go for this foundation. Now I'm going to take my blender and I'm going to blend my foundation in just dabbing motion. So you can see my foundation is nicely blended and it looks so natural. So that's pretty much it. Damp Spawns gives a really nice coverage, so that's the whole point for me. If you want, you can definitely layer this with a concealer, but I personally don't like layering my base in winters. So that's pretty much it for my base. So the third makeup tip, or the one thing that you must avoid in winters, is layering your base with powder. So if your under eye crease a lot, you can use a compact and you can just use the same damp sponge to set your under eyes with it. Like under eye crease a lot, इसी की help से अपने under eye को set करा है ताकि मेरी under eye बिल्कुल भी crease ना करे. Although मैंने बहुत कम product अपने under eye पर भी लगाया था, but still मैं under eye creases, so that's why मैंने बस अपनी under eye को set करा है. Rest, if you don't have a oily skin, you can leave your base like this. I totally go for a non-compact base in winters. Compacts make your face look much drier, dehydrated. So winters may dehydrated skin looks so dry. So the fourth thing to avoid is using a powder blush in winters. So less blush and more tint. So you know I have DIY'd a tint for myself. So I'm gonna use this tint for my cheeks as well, so to get a really nice healthy looking cheeks using a brush. You can see I have used a lot. I'm going to use the same damp sponge to blend this. You can see how natural it looks. You can see the tint is looking very natural. So that's pretty much it. Stop using powder blushes, go for tint. If you want a DIY recipe, I will be sharing it on my channel soon. This is also a DIY product. So I did my eyebrows, so that's something which I do not skip even if it's winter, summer, monsoon or autumn. So the fifth tip is to use mousse eyeshadows for your eyelids in winters. So if you don't know how to apply an eyeshadow, I have a tutorial on that too. But still, if you don't want to learn how to apply eyeshadow, that's completely a different story. So you can definitely invest in mousse eyeshadow. So this is from Swiss Beauty. This palette is really affordable. I will put down the link. So all you can do is you can take a nice mousse shadow, because these are really creamy and they blend so beautifully. So you don't need a separate eye product, so you just need to take them and you can blend it using your fingers and you're pretty much sorted. So for today I'm gonna take this color. This is really gorgeous color. So I'm gonna take my fingers, the pigmentation, see, crazy, and I'm gonna apply it all over my eyelid, see. And I'm also gonna take a nice fluffy brush. This is from Shein, again very affordable brushes, and I'm gonna use my brush to blend it all over my lid. So that's it. I have long nails, basically I have nail extensions on my nails, so that's why I'm not using my fingers. You can also use your fingers to blend this. So this is pretty much it. This looks so blingy, watery and graceful at the same time, and you have just used a single palette and a single shade to do your eyes. I'm gonna be taking the same palette. I'm gonna take a very small brush, repeat the step onto my waterline, like very lightly, because these are mousse shadows. ये अच्छे से इधर अप्लाई नहीं होगा. So that's pretty much it. You can now see I haven't used much product, but my eye still looks really fine. So I'm gonna curl and apply some mascara. So you can see the difference. See how easy it is to achieve this eye makeup. I know this pimple looks really weird right now, but it's just that this pimple is healing, so avoid this pimple. So these are pretty much the tips I wanted to share. Now you can use your highlighter go for a liquid highlighters because they look more pretty in winter. But I know a lot of you only have a powder one, so I'm gonna be using this only. So yep. So I've just applied a lipstick and I use my NYX lip lingerie in 12. I think this is in the shade Exotic. Yeah, this is in the shade Exotic. If you want a really natural look, you can directly apply a tint, because I love using a tint these days. So yeah, that's all for today. I only wanted to share these 5 tips because these 5 tips makes a huge difference in your makeup. But yeah, that was all for today. I hope you like this video, and if you like these kind of videos, do let me know in the comment section below. And for more such videos, stay tuned. Bye. Mwah.